the Canaan lady got an offering. You have one to do so. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Thank you.
God be glorified.
You have to ride to one person. Yes, if you have one. Amen. Now we're going to go on.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You got Genesis
32.
And 24. Thank you, God. Glory to God. Amen. Thank you, God. Glory to God. There's somebody there. Right now, we're going to be talking about Jacob.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to be talking about Jacob a little bit.
Amen.
Then we're going to go over to Matthew. I want you to get Matthew 27. Amen. So that you will have those that won't hinder you.
Amen.
Amen. Are we reading now?
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Thank you, man. Glory to God, to the Father, the Spirit of the Lord. And I will all take it out of my son, that he is in my God. Glory to God, I want you to exercise your gift. Stand up. More than what you do.
Amen.
I don't care if you have to get out there and prophesy to the tree.
Hallelujah.
Y'all ain't saying that. Get the prophesying to them dry bones. Hallelujah. When God has you on an assignment, and he got a work for you to do, you don't wait on nobody else. Glory to God, you got to go for your own self. And I believe there's a gift down on the inside of you. But you got to exercise your gift for your own self.
Amen.
When you say amen. You got to do it for yourself.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Prophesy to the fire. He run around and command them to go out the door, y'all.
Come on.
And let God minister to you.
Yes.
Amen. That's more than your gift. That's exercising your gift.
Yes.
Okay. Genesis 24, what, 32?
Genesis 24.
Okay. Who gonna read for me?
Right here.
Okay.
Come on. Amen.
And he took, and Jacob was left alone. And Jacob was left alone at this particular time. And so, every now and then, and the apostle was in at this moment, you got to walk alone. You got to be alone.
Amen.
But we always want somebody crowding around us.
All right.
We always want somebody right there with us.
Amen.
But when there's a special work for you to do, you got to walk alone.
Amen.
You have to walk alone.
Amen.
You got to be alone.
Amen.
But then you're not alone. In the spirit, but you're not always alone in the spirit. But we always want somebody right here with us. But this was a time when God was beginning to deal with Jacob. So he was alone, come on.
And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of day.
Now don't you know, when God is getting ready to carry you somewhere, y'all ain't saying nothing. He's gonna change your whole identity.
Yeah.
I see the Holy Ghost. He's gonna change what you used to be.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing.
In order for you to go somewhere, there got to be a change.
Yeah.
They got to come a change.
Right.
And where he
that he prevailed not against him.
Now he said he wrestled with a man.
Oh, y'all ain't said
it. See, God was getting ready to change him at this particular time. There was a new identity. Was getting ready to come.
Oh, y'all ain't said it.
Sometimes when y'all get ready to bless you, you got to wrestle with some things.
He wrestled with the man until the breaking.
He wrestled with the man until the breaking of the day.
And when he saw that he prevailed not against
now,
him,
when he saw vice versa, the man saw him and he saw the man. But sometimes we are quick. But the Bible says he didn't prevail. He kept on going. Why? Because he knew that the man had something that he needed.
He touched the hollow of his thigh.
So he touched, he wrestled so. And the Bible says he touched the hollow of his thigh.
And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint.
So that. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
And you Americans wrestling with a bank robber. And he got just the amount of money you need. $100 million. Y'all don't care if they pull your arm off. As long as you get what you need.
Come on.
Glory to God. So the man had something that Jacob wanted. So even when he tore his thigh,